If you're embarrassed about your car because every time you turn on your AC, fire blows out the vents, maybe you're even losing some friends or something out of the deal, well, I'll tell you what, stay tuned because we're going to try to fix it. So today I'm going to show you how to refill the AC system in your car. So what you need is a good set of gauges. You need a scale. Here I have a scale, recycler, and vacuum pump. It's all built in. But if you don't have a full unit, most people won't. You're just going to need a scale and a vacuum pump. And then also you need whatever you're going to put in it. So there's a refrigerant we're going to use. Some people use the cans. Maybe I'll talk briefly about that. Full disclosure, if you don't feel comfortable doing this, please don't do it. Today is quite hot. There it is. It's 32 degrees centigrade. So I'll throw up the Fahrenheit too. But for those that don't know, the high side of an AC system can approach 300 PSI on a hot day. So very, very important. You don't want to get hurt, injury. It's just not worth it. If you don't feel comfortable, please take it in to someone else. Now, like a professional is what I mean. So for this vehicle in particular, we must evacuate it because it's been open to the air. The condenser was leaking, so I replaced the condenser. So now I'm going to fill it up. So first what I have to do is draw a vacuum on the system. So I'm going to hook up the machine and do that right now. All right, so we're going to want to find the ports on our vehicle. For this Honda Civic, H high side, L low side, our ports are right there. They're very, very easy to access. So we're just going to unscrew them. We don't want to lose them, so just put them where you're not going to forget to put them back on. There's our low side. Now, just a general sort of fun fact, the low side is always the bigger and thicker hose or line, if you want to call that. High side is always a small one, always. So let's get our cables like so. So there's our high side. And our low side is on. All right, now in this vehicle, I can't just charge it up and add the charge. The reason is I fixed the condenser. The condenser was leaking, so I replaced it. So because it's been open to the atmosphere, what we have to do is we actually have to draw a vacuum. What a vacuum will do, without getting into a physics lesson, the lower the pressure, the easier something boils. So when you have low pressure on your system, basically it's under a vacuum, all the moisture should boil out of the system. So let's go over to the machine and we're gonna set it up on vacuum. Now, there's no reason for me to explain exactly how this machine works because you'll have your own type of vacuum pump. But what's important is to vacuum for a decent amount of time. I like to do it for at least 30 minutes. There we go. So now what we're going to do is we're going to open up our valves here. And you can actually see we're drawing a vacuum. There you go. We're drawing a vacuum on the system. So that's good. It'll vacuum out the system, vacuum out any moisture. So while it's doing that, I'll just briefly speak about, we're going to be putting in RedTek R12A. I've had a few people contact me, ask me how well it works. So this is an older vehicle, so actually I've used it in quite a few vehicles, and it does work fairly well. Now the other thing we should talk about is if you have cans and you want to put a can in, there's a problem. With newer vehicles, they really don't take much. So for example, this vehicle here, this Honda Civic, let's look over the manual here. So if we're looking at Civic, we can see here it's a 2006, so it takes about a pound of refrigerant. So really, that's not much at all. So when we go over to our cans, a pound is 16 ounces. So this can is basically all you could put in it, because if you put two cans of this stuff in, you would overfill it and you can actually wreck it. So it's important to know how much is in your system. Now we know because we're evacuating it, there's gonna be absolutely nothing in, and I can weigh it in with the scale so we can get a perfect charge. So I have the car running. You can see the car is running and we have it on max AC, all the way cold. Okay, and we can see that's our temperature. So it's not cooling at all. It's a hot day. It's actually much hotter outside, but I have it in the garage because it's cooler. So now we're going to start charging up the system and we'll see how the vents change temperature. So the machine is done and we are still holding a vacuum. So that's great. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to close off the valves. Okay, that's very important. There we go. We're going to close off the valves. Now the reason I had to close off these valves is this center line here. that runs all the way to the recycler machine, I have to disconnect that because I have to connect that line to the tank. All right, so I don't get a take two on this, so we only get take one on this because we just got to purge the line once. So right now there's air in the line because, like I said, I've disconnected this from the machine that was providing the suction. Similar if you had a vacuum pump, you'd have to disconnect this from the vacuum pump and then you'd have to connect this to your feed supply of refrigerant. So now there's air in this line, but there's no air in these lines. There's still a vacuum, as you can see, because the valves are still shut. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna crack this line just a little bit and we're just gonna purge any air and you'll actually see the refrigerant. There you go. So now this line is full of refrigerant and there's no more air. So now once I crack these lines, it'll be pure refrigerant going into these lines. And if anyone's wondering if it was illegal for me to do this, no, it was not, because we're using RedTek. Throw up a little picture thing. There's no license required. And it's not supposed to damage the environment. So what I did is just, it's perfectly fine. Now, an important thing to check on AC systems is whether or not your compressor is running. So there's the compressor right down there at the bottom. I'm just gonna sort of hold it here a bit. I'm gonna throw up an arrow. That center part should be spinning when it's actually working. When it's not working, it will be stationary and the belt will still move. So that's really important. And normally, to get the compressor running, you should only need about an ounce. So we shouldn't have to put much in there at all. It should only be about an ounce to get it going. That's all we need. Now, when we go over to our RedTek chart to see what we're gonna be putting in, you can see there, this car takes about a pound. We looked it up. So 1 pound is only 6 ounces of this RedTek stuff. So we're only gonna weigh in 6 ounces and that will give us the same as the 1 pound that it came with from the factory. So we look at what's in the tank right now. We got 19 pounds in the tank. So with 19 pounds in the tank, and all we have to do is hit the amount button there again and again, and it'll show us 19 pounds in a tank. We need to put 6 ounces in the car, but we have to remember we still have Freon, or, well, it's actually not Freon, but our refrigerant in the hoses, and that's got to amount for something. So I really only want to put in about 4 ounces, and then the rest, which is in the hoses, should be fine. So, and whenever we enter and charge a system, we're always going to charge it on the low side. It's much easier to charge it on the low side. I charge with liquid. So you got, when you're charging with liquid, you got to be very careful how much you throttle in, because if you put too much liquid in too fast, you'll damage it. So you can charge much faster with liquid, but you got to be careful. A lot of guys say you can charge with gas, and basically, just explain it very briefly, if you had this way and you were charging, it would be gas mostly coming out. If you had it down like this, the liquid would come out first. So it's just important, you can charge faster with liquid, but you have to be very careful. All right, so we're gonna start the vehicle. So the vehicle is started, there you go. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it on vents. We want it on vents. We want AC max, recirc, that's fine. All the way cold, just like this. You can see it's at 96 Fahrenheit, so it's, or 95.8, whatever. There you go, it's actually cooling a little bit and the car's not even running. What this is it's just air movement that's cooling the thermometer because it was sitting there. If I just turn it up like this, we can let it just run for a bit and it won't get too much cold. There you go, it stopped there pretty much. That's where it's gonna be. And that's just because of the airflow, but 94 is still way too hot. It's not even working, so let's go outside the car and have a look. So now I'm gonna start putting the refrigerant in. You can see we're still holding a vacuum. We're still good there. And we still have our 19 pounds in our tank, which is great. So no more than 6 ounces. So I'm just gonna start it off on the low side. Here's my low side. And I'm gonna crack the valve, just leave it, there you go. And the compressor, once we have about an ounce, it should turn on. So I want you to see this compressor turn on. So I'm putting some in there. And as you can see, very slowly, I'm just putting it in, just like that. There you go. I don't want you guys to miss this. There you go, and it just turned on. So it just turned on, I closed the valve, we're running on almost no pressure at all, and I want to show you how much we took out of the tank to trigger that compressor. There you go, barely an ounce, because it was flickering between 19 pounds and 19.1 is what it was flickering. So basically, it probably took half an ounce to trigger that compressor. So it really doesn't take much to trigger that compressor. So now, let's start filling this. Again, so we're gonna crack our valve open. Now when we're filling, we don't wanna go over about 30 pounds, okay? We don't wanna have too much, and actually you can see here, there we go, there's the refrigerant there, there's the liquid there. Now if you crack this open, like I said, it's gonna go in too fast. And you can see our high side's building up too. Now this RedTek runs at a lower pressure than 134A, and it'll get cold. So we can actually open it up a little bit more there. And we can close it off a bit there. You can see we can kind of throttle it. We want to keep it around the 30 mark. And if we look down here, you see our compressor there is still running. So that's awesome. Now what we want to do is we don't want to forget about what's in the tank. So we can even close this off a bit. Let's go check how much we actually put in there. Okay, so we put about 2 ounces in there. So we still got a few more ounces to go, maybe another 2 ounces. So we're gonna go here and we're gonna open this up. I don't wanna go much more in there. Let's close her off. And let's take another check, see how much is in there. Okay, so I put in about another ounce. So you can see how slowly it actually goes in. I take my time putting it in. I don't try to ram it in there really fast because I'm just asking for trouble. Now I'm just thinking out loud in my head. So we're at around 19. We're at 19 pounds and it was zero, so that was pretty good. So now if we go back here, we're at 12. So 13, 14, 15, 16. So we've actually put 4 ounces in there right now. So 4 ounces are in the vehicle. So you know what, let's go inside the vehicle and check the thermometer. There's our gauges. They're looking good. It's running 32 pounds on the low side. High side's just under 150. Remember, this RedTek stuff runs at a lower pressure than 134A. If we were using 134A, these pressures would be a little bit higher. So let's check the temperature inside. And I am back inside the vehicle, and you can see, nice. It's really cooling down. And once you drive and you get airflow, it'll even cool down even more. You gotta remember the car is sitting in a garage right now and it's not driving, it's just at idle. So we've put our 4 ounces in there and we need 6, but you know what, we easily probably have close to 2 ounces in the lines. So what I might do is just give it another ounce and then we'll just purge whatever's in the line into the vehicle. I'll show you how to do that. And you can actually see the fluid there. And what this fluid is this fluid is from this line, the feed line. Right now I have the valves actually closed. The valves are closed, so this is the pressure on what the vehicle's running. So I'm gonna put a little bit more in, and there you can see it's right there. I'm just gonna put a little bit more in. And there you go, that should be good. That should be all we need. Let's go back here. We're still at 12. I wanna make sure I get a full 4 in there. And there you go, that's good. It's still hitting on the 12, so that's good, but we know we've got to sort at the bottom. So anyway, that's good. Now we know we're good. So what we want to do now is we want to shut off our feed line, which is our tank. So let's go over to our tank and shut it off. So I'm going to turn off the feed hose. So here's the feed hose. I'm just going to turn it off. There we go, we're going to turn it off. And now this hose actually goes all the way to the bottom of the gauges. So if I stand up here, that's this hose. It goes to the bottom of the gauges. It's turned off now. So if I undid this, we would waste an ounce or two, right? So we would just waste it. So we don't want to do that. So what we're going to do instead now is now I can open this up. Here we go. I'm going to open it up. And we're going to empty this hose. There we go. Pressure slowly coming down. Now I've opened it all the way. So the valve's opened all the way. And you can see the fluid is getting less and less. It's very hot outside, so it may take a bit to get rid of this. But we'll get rid of all the fluid. This will disappear, and then there'll just be a little bit of gas in the hose, almost nothing. So this way, we didn't have to waste all that liquid that was in the hose, and you can actually see it's almost gone right now. There was a lot more when we were filling with the halfway point, but now you can see there's almost nothing there. So if you've noticed, during the whole video, I've never opened up the high side, so whatever you do, don't open the high side, because if you open the high side, you release all this pressure into the other side, it's just not good. So the only thing I've used the high side for is just to monitor. It's connected to the vehicle, and I can see the pressure. The pressure is where I want it to be right now, and I'm just monitoring. I've never touched this valve through the whole process today, never touched it. I've done everything through the low side, so that's very, very important to do everything through the low side. And right now the low side's totally open. You can see the valve, and you can see now there, look, there's absolutely nothing left in there. So we've totally purged this line going to our refrigerant. And then what we can do is now we can close this line off, just like so. Now we're safe to disconnect this from the tank. The tank has already been shut off. You saw me shut that off earlier. And then we can pop those off. But first, let's take a quick walk around and check out the vehicle. And let's see what the temperature is inside. So let's take a look. And as you can see there you go. It's even cooling off more. So that is nice. Nice, cool vehicle. AC is working great. So I'm planning another video on how to properly put these in your vehicle if you're going to use cans. Obviously not everyone's got a gauge set and an evacuation system like this. So I'm going to do another video that should be up hopefully in the next few weeks. I'm just waiting for a few things for that because this seems to be the popular thing. A lot of people do this. This was the proper way to fill it. You saw we actually evacuated it. We drew a vacuum. We totally evacuated it. We measured what went in so we know exactly how much is in the system. So this is the proper way to do it. Now a trick that I learned to disconnecting the hoses is disconnect the low side when the vehicle is running, because as you can see there's not much pressure there. It's only 35 pounds. So all we have to do is disconnect here, and actually you can see there's water on it, so it's doing well, it's cooling. So now valves are off, everything is off. So now we can just disconnect it just like that, and it just popped off nice easy. This one now, the high side, you can see right now, just over 150 pounds. So what we're going to do is we're going to shut the vehicle off. You'll see this pressure will come down, and then we can undo the hose. It'll be a little bit less pressure. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. GarageKing over and out. Hopefully I'll see you on the next one. Everyone have a great day, and stay cool out there.